Hello guys, what's up? I came across a discussion within the ROG ALLY community regarding disabling CPU core boost performance that is found in power options. Claims say that disabling it conserves power without compromising performance. But by testing, I've observed a different result, which I'd like to share with you. To start off, I ran Cinebench CPU benchmark for both multi and single cores, comparing the performance with CPU core boost disabled versus the efficient aggressive mode. Here are the scores with core boost disabled. For multi-core, it's 11,772 and single core 1,161. Heading to hardware info, we notice the max frequency reached around 3.3 GHz. Temperature-wise, the maximum reading is 74 degrees, while the max power drawn is 25 watts. Let's repeat the test with efficient aggressive mode enabled. This time, we observe a remarkable performance increase with scores of 14,264 for multi-core and 1,785 for single-core. Hardware info shows a max frequency of 5.1 GHz, which is the boost clock speed of the Z1 Extreme. The maximum die temperature rises to 95 degrees, and that is totally within the thermal limits for Zen 4 CPUs. As for the max power drawn, it increased to 45 watts, which is also within the specs range for the Z1 Extreme. Even games can have irregular behaviors with the CPU boost disabled. For instance, in Age of Empires 2 Definitive Edition, the performance noticeably lags behind with the boost disabled. That's because real-time strategy games are more CPU dependent. But yes, there is a difference of power draw, 15 watts with CPU boost disabled versus 30 watts when it's enabled. In GTA 5 benchmark, the disabled configuration surprisingly draws the same power, peaking at 49 watts, which is the same as efficient aggressive. The disabled has lower FPS in general, if you see here. And from what I can also tell from this, that since we have boost disabled, there is extra power budget that is being unused, and the GPU is trying to take advantage of that. As you see, it has higher clock speed in disabled. It's causing the same power draw as when you have CPU boost enabled. At least that's what I can tell by doing this. While the results in Cyberpunk 2077 are a bit different, the GPU clock speed this time is not any higher, while the efficient aggressive mode is able to push the CPU clock speed higher at some points, while keeping the same temp and power draw. So after testing with Zeus Heavy Games and Cinebench, it seems clear to me that disabling CPU boost isn't a wise choice. The CPU is designed by AMD, not ASUS, and the engineers behind it understand its behavior better than we do. They designed the CPU to boost up to 5.1 GHz, balancing performance and efficiency as much as possible. Tinkering with this might actually give the opposite effect. If we focus on Cinebench scores alone, they are higher in efficient aggressive mode by 21% for multi-core and 54% for single-core. A question I would like to ask everyone, including myself. Why would anyone want to limit the performance of their ROG Ally? If the focus is conserving battery life, consider selecting performance mode or creating your own profile that has lower power limit. While it's connected to a power adapter or docking station, you will be better off aiming to extract the maximum performance that the Z1 Extreme can offer. And by the way, looking at the Z1 Extreme specs page, you will see that the base clock speed is 3.3 GHz, and when you have CPU boost enabled, it can boost up to 5.1 GHz. You've paid for those specs, so why not fully utilize them? As a user of other Zen 4 based desktop CPU, I can fully attest that enabling the boost can significantly enhance overall performance, from RAM utilization to simple tasks to gaming as well. I have tested all other boost modes and found that efficient aggressive will be the best candidate. This way, the CPU will try to be efficient when possible, but still boost aggressively when needed. At the end, our opinions may vary. I only hope this information proves helpful in knowing the other side of tinkering with this option. I want to thank you for watching. If you like my content, don't forget to subscribe for more insights, and I'll see you in the next one.